Welcome to Queen's Public Library. This is Leah from Hillcrest. Thank you for joining us. Today we'll be looking at our online summer reading platform, READsquared. First, go to summerreading.queenslibrary.org. Just type that into your browser and we'll bring you to this page. This is our summer reading website. I absolutely encourage you to explore the rest of the site, but today we're going to be looking specifically at READsquared. On READsquared, you'll be able to track your summer reading, earn badges, play games, and complete challenges. We'll be adding new content as the summer progresses, so check back frequently. So we're going to click right here on Join READsquared Now. So before you log in, this is the homepage, and if you need to, you can translate the page, if you go all the way down right over here, select your language to whichever language you would like. So the first thing to do in order to get started is to register for an account. You could do that right over here in the corner. If possible, you may want to have your library card numbers handy before you begin. They are an optional component of registration. You don't need your library card number, but if you want to add it into your account, you'd like to grab that first. So you can choose to register just yourself or your whole family at once so that there's just one login to remember. You also could just register yourself and add children's sub-accounts later on. So let's say you're registering for yourself and children. First, you're going to be creating the adult account. So you're going to select your age range as an adult. And then they're going to want you to fill in just basic information to complete your profile. Okay. All right, so I just logged in. I'm registered now. Once you've registered, you're going to be viewing your dashboard. You earn badges for completing different activities. So here you just earned one for registering. Now you've started your journey. So this is your avatar over here. You can change it up a little bit if you'd like. There are different kinds for adults and children. And you can edit your account settings like your username over here. You can toggle between different family members over here. So I made a parent account and a child account. And I could take a look at the child account and just switch back and forth whenever I want to. All right, so one of the most important components of summer reading is, of course, reading. You can log your reading right over here. All the fields are optional, except, of course, for the minutes read, because that's the most important one. You're going to want to put in just a number here. Don't write minutes, just write the number. You could add in the book title or the author. It will autocomplete for you. And what you're able to do is you're able to select whoever in the family participated in the reading, so everybody gets credit. You could give a book a rating if you want, put in the stars for how much you liked it, add a review. You can go back and edit your review whenever you want. You can also review a book without having logged the reading by clicking over here. And the history button is going to be giving you just a summary of all that you've logged so far this summer. So this is what I put in for the baby's account. Okay, missions are challenges that our librarians set up. So completing challenges can earn you badges, and at the end of the summer, you're going to get a certificate. The big mission for the month of June is our 20-20-20 challenge to read for 20 minutes a day for 20 days in 2020. If you finish this mission, then you would get this badge. And you can see on the home dashboard all the badges that you could earn. So there's that. Once you earn the badge, they get colored in. Okay, so reading list is going to bring you to a collection of curated reading lists that were developed by our librarians. If you want to add any of these books to your wish list, you can. So let's take a look at the early learner book list. So you can add it to your wish list. You can take a look at the Goodreads reviews. You can see it in the library's catalog, and you can check out ebooks. Or if you already read it, you can log the book. Of course, you do not read to do. You don't need to read books specifically from this list. We want you to read any book that you want. So read books that you love, and you can log your reading. It doesn't need to be from this list specifically. So also have some fun extras here. Games are unlocked as you advance in your summer reading and earn badges. A child's account will have different options here than an adult account. Child account, this one, it's all unlocked. But if I switch to the adult account, then you'll see that only the first two are unlocked. So you can also see the game board is going to be filled in as you go along, as you advance. And reviews are your chance to give your opinion on a book that you've read. So the reviews are going to be moderated by a panel of librarians and will only be published after their approval. So if you love the book, or if you just didn't get why people like it, you can voice your thoughts here for other readers to see. All right. We hope you love using our summer reading website. Make sure to follow the Queen's Public Library on social media to enjoy our virtual summer programs happening all day, every day. Happy reading, and stay safe.